But today we're doing lunges, step ups, squats, wall march, ball twist, and bridge walkout. So we're going to go right into it. So the first one is lunges. Of course, I think you all know that lunges are important for running. So remember, you want to step out and lunge forward. Your main goal is to have a 90-degree bend in that leg, as well as not allowing that knee to track over the toe. Okay, so your goal is 20 repetitions. Give beginner one set, intermediate two sets, and advanced three sets. So shoulders are down and back, core's engaged, and you're pushing off that front leg, driving that heel back, and contracting that glute. 20 repetitions on each side, okay? You can alternate, just stay on one leg, whatever works for you. The next exercise is step up. You can have a bench, or maybe you're gonna be upstairs, and you're gonna stay on the same foot, okay? So you're gonna plant that one of your legs up on the bench or step. Make sure you keep that 90-degree bend. You don't want to be too high because then you're gonna risk injuring yourself. So it's toes tracking head, knees tracking head, and then you're just gonna step up and back down. And shoulders back, find that balance. You want to contract that supporting leg, okay? Nice and controlled, down and back. So I'm going to do five on each side. Nice and controlled. And then just change and alternate to the opposite foot. Make sure everything's nice and squared up. Running motion arms, right? So cheek to pocket. Up, contract that glute. Make sure you're coming up. Nice and controlled. All right, and the next exercise is your squat. So you want to make sure that everything's lined up. Your hips are even, taking that water in your crystal, shoulders are back, and elbows is turning, push through your hips and pelvis, and you're squatting down and back, okay? The goal is to get your thighs to parallel, but if you can go deeper, go lower into that squat. As you're coming up, you're driving your heels, contracting the glutes, okay? So we all squat every day, right? Sit in the chair, you know, go to the bathroom, all those things is a squatting motion. Okay, but this one I want you to fully engage and contracting, stressing as you go up. The next exercise is going to require a stability ball. So I think most of you guys have these already. So we're going to do a ball march, okay? So if you want to safely get on the ball, you're going to walk out to your shoulders, are on the ball, okay? So I'm gonna make sure I'm in here, okay? So your shoulders are on the ball, they're contracting the glutes, so hips are squared like they're in anger, and pull it up towards the ceiling. You're gonna find your balance, your hands can go somewhere you feel comfortable, and you're just gonna march it out, okay? Nice and controlled, so you find that balance. First, contract the core. Focus on the glutes. Okay. Nice and controlled. Obviously, my right side is a little bit weaker. And again, it's about finding the balance. Pressing the heel. Keep the hips up. And the goal is to complete 20 repetitions. Okay. The next exercise also is on the ball. It's a ball twist. Okay. Four on four. We do some rotation and running. And of course, swinging tightly, not so much. Your palms are going to come together. Your hips are parallel. Pressing through the heels, contracting the glutes. And you're just going to push over to one side. Okay. Nice and controlled. Coming to the center. Another repetition on each side. Just do the rotation. Okay, your rotation is probably going to be a little bit different than mine. I'm a little limited right now. I'm working on that goal. Okay, and one repetition on each side. And the last exercise is a bridge walkout. Okay, so you're going to come all the way down to the ground. Remember, fingertips are touching here. You're going to grab the pelvis, posterior, and tilt it. Navel towards your spine. Hands are right by you. You're going to lift up onto your shoulders. Contracting the hips. And you're just going to walk those legs out. Okay? Walk one step only and bring it back to the back to starting position. You can alternate and stay on one side. whatever's most comfortable to you. The main thing is that you maintain the grip and maintain the stability of those hips and core. Okay? So you're walking it out. And back. You're going to feel those glutes fire, okay? As well as your core trying to help stabilize, which is very, very important as you're running. Okay, going with some repetitions. Thank you for joining me today on day 5.